You study these extreme environments and how we can acclimate to those extreme environments. So tell us about that.
So some people are what we would call dippers. They will maybe even cut a hole in the ice and jump in and jump out again. Other people will go in for a limited amount of time, maybe 5-10 minutes. It pushes your blood pressure up. You can lose control of your breathing. You know, it's not something to be undertaken lightly. And so you do it under supervision and do it with other people and in a controlled way.
What are some of the reported health benefits they can expect from this cold water immersion?
Well, a lot of people talk about feeling alert and awake and alive. And of course, plunge into 0 degree water or even water below 15 degrees Celsius, about 59, 60 Fahrenheit, is a pretty stressful stimulus. And it releases all the stress hormones. And that's what's alerting you, that fight or flight response. And the final thing you'll hear people talk about who do lots of cold water exposures is, I haven't had a cold for a year. I'm never ill. My immune system is fantastic. And again, it's largely anecdotal, but there is a body of evidence emerging that certainly short dips in cold water may activate or prepare the immune system. And there's this cross adaptation.
What would you classify as a short dip, just for our viewers? Oh, okay. A short dip.
We certainly wouldn't recommend people go in for any more than 10 minutes, because after that you can start to cool the superficial nerves and muscles and lose the ability to swim or to help yourself. But the cold shock response, as we called it back in the 80s, is that gasping, shocking response that you get. We think that that may be the thing that's triggering some of the immune preparedness and obviously that alerting response. But that's 1 or 2 minutes in the water.
On that note, back to Sue, are you going to take us through one of your ice plunges?
I am. And just to touch on the time, what we generally recommend is that all of the benefits that you receive from a cold plunge take place between 90 seconds and 2 minutes. So it's long. 90 seconds is a long time in a ice bath. The water right now is 0 degrees Celsius. Oh dear, I forgot what that is in Fahrenheit. So it's pretty cold. So why don't I
why don't you take the plunge and...
So you take the plunge, Sue.
And a warning, don't do this at home.
No, you need to be trained to do this. So give me a minute to just get into my... I'm in my bathing suit, but to get undressed. And I have to axe the hole because in the period of time that we've been waiting to get started, it froze over. So I'll be right with you. Okay.
Mike, is this something you do yourself or just study?
Well, there's a long tradition in human physiology that you're your first subject or experimental subject. So I'm only 23 years old. It's just I've done a lot of study.
Look at this.
I know, as you can see.
we're watching Sue create her plunge hole. I mean, the thing froze over on her. She's hacking away with her axe, getting a little extra exercise. We're watching her. This is something else.
That's big enough.
Yeah, I think you'll fit in that.
But this has really exploded in the last year or so. Maybe it's, to do with being locked down. I mean, my local club has gone from 25 members to 2,000 in the course of a few months.